first developed by Canadian aeronautics company Avro Aircraft Limited in the midst of the Cold War, the flying saucer-shaped VZ-9 Avrocar was originally intended as a supersonic fighter bomber. It was designed to utilize a phenomenon known as the Kawanda effect to provide lift and thrust from a center-mounted turbo rotor. The project was eventually taken over by the US military, with the Air Force seeking a craft that could hover below enemy radar before launching to supersonic speeds, and the Army desiring an all-terrain troop transport that could lift off and land vertically. Several test vehicles were built, but the project was abandoned as the Avrocar could never reach speeds beyond 35 miles per hour without losing control. Designed by Charles H. Zimmerman, the Vought V-173 was part of the U.S. Navy's Flying Flapjack program during World War II. The U.S. Navy was seeking a ship-launch fighter with short takeoff and landing capabilities to counter Japanese submarines and kamikazes. The entire body of the plane provided lift, and its massive 16.5-foot counter-rotating propellers allowed it to hover nearly in place. The Stubby Xf 85 Goblin was a jet fighter aircraft intended to be dropped from the bomb bay of the Northrop XB-35 and B-36 bombers that were under development. Existing fighters could not match the range of these new bombers, so the Air Force sought to create an interceptor that could be carried by the bombers and launched when needed. The project was cancelled due to the Goblin's poor performance against larger jet fighters and its difficulties redocking with the mothership bomber. The Grumman X-29 was one of the most unusual aircraft designs in history, serving as a testing platform for multiple advanced technologies, including forward swept wings, canard control surfaces, and new composite materials. This combination of features made the X-29 inherently unstable, requiring a computerized flight control system that made 40 corrections per second. The X-29 demonstrated extreme maneuverability, and it became the first forward swept wing aircraft to achieve supersonic speed at level flight. Never destined for production, the program was concluded in 1992 with its successful tech being passed to future aircraft. At a time when supersonic fighter designs required long takeoff rolls and high-speed landings that prevented operation from the decks of aircraft carriers, the U.S. Navy commissioned Convair to create a supersonic seaplane interceptor. A delta-winged fighter with a floating watertight hull and retractable hydro skis, the F2Y Sea Dart was designed to take off and land in open water near carrier groups and sea bases. Several Sea Dart prototypes were created in the 1950s, with one design becoming the first and only seaplane to break the sound barrier.